Hello everyone, today in this video we will discuss about the digestive and respiratory system of labio. So this is the diagram of digestive system of labio. Here first we will discuss about the alimentary canal and then we will discuss about the digestive glands. This is the diagram of alimentary canal. So the teeth and a distinct tongue is absent in labio. The anterior part of pharynx is respiratory and the posterior part of the pharynx is masticatory. So this is the anterior part of pharynx which is respiratory and this is the posterior part of pharynx which is masticatory. Then anterior part of pharynx is perforated by laterally 4 pairs of internal gill slits leading into branchial chambers. Then gill rakers are present which prevent the passage of food into gill slits. So gill rakers helps in the prevention of passage of food into gill slits. Posterior pharyngeal gill chamber, this one bears 3 rows of homodont teeth or masticating plates with truncated crowns for crushing and grinding food. So teeth are present in posterior pharynx which are masticatory in function, that is crushing and grinding of food. Then teeth are borne by inferior pharyngeal bone. Then anuvantic duct from air bladder of fish opens dorsally into esophagus. So pneumatic duct opens into this is the opening of pneumatic duct, this one in the esophagus, this is the esophagus. Then labio do not have a stomach, so stomach is absent and the esophagus in continuous in the intestine behind. Then esophagus opens into intestinal bulb, this is the intestinal bulb, this one intestinal bulb, and this is the cardiac part of intestinal bulb. And the opening of esophagus into intestinal bulb of cardiac part is guarded by an esophageal wall to prevent regurgitation of food. Then the intestinal bulb has an anterior this one the broader cardiac part into which pancreatic and bile duct opens, and a posterior narrower pyloric part without pyloric ceca which is so common in other teleus fissures. So pyloric ceca is absent in this one. Then mucus lining of this cardiac part shows honeycomb like folds and pyloric part contains longitudinal folds. This pyloric part contain longitudinal folds whereas the anterior cardiac part has honeycomb like folds. And gastric glands are absent in intestinal bulbs. Then in this intestine the intestine mucus lining forms oblique transverse folds, and in its anterior region and distinct longitudinal folds in its posterior region. So this is the posterior intestine and this is the anterior intestine, this one anterior intestine, this is the posterior intestine. And before intestine between esophagus and intestine there is an intestinal bulb with cardiac and pyloric part which represents the stomach, but it is not a stomach. So the anterior part of intestine and the posterior part of intestine. In anterior part of intestine there are oblique transverse folds, and in posterior part of intestine there are longitudinal transverse folds. Pyloric ceca, intestinal villi and skull wall are absent in the labio. Intestinal is longer in labio because it is herbivorous fish, but it tends to be shorter in carnivorous fishes such as in scalodon. So intestine is shorter in carnivorous fishes and it is longer in herbivorous fishes, and the labio is herbivorous fish, so intestine is longer in labio. Rectal gland is absent, which is present in scalodon. And then next, the digestive glands and liver, gallbladder, three hepatic ducts forms a bile duct. So here are these hepatic ducts which forms a bile duct. This is the formation of bile duct by the hepatic ducts, and which opens dorsally into the roof of the cardiac part of intestinal bulb with the pancreatic duct. So this is all about the digestive system and intestinal alimentary canal and the digestive glands. Next, in this video we will discuss about the respiratory system of labio. There are four pairs of filiform gills present in the labio. Four gills are present on either side of the pharynx in a common gill chamber. This is the branchial chamber. And the gill chamber is covered externally by a skin flap called operculum. This is the operculum which covers the four pair of gills. Then the chamber opens to outside by a large branchial or gill aperture and behind the operculum. Each gill consists of two rows of gill filaments. So in each gill there are two rows of gill filaments. These are the gill filaments in section, two rows of gill filaments in each gill, and this type of gill is called filiform or pectinate gill. Thus there are eight hemibranchs or four hollow branchs only attached to first four branchial arches and fifth gill slit on either side beneath an operculum. So there are four hollow branchs or eight hemibranchs are present in labio. Gill rakers do not permit food particles to enter the gill chamber. And this is all about the respiratory system of the scalodon, which uses the oxygen dissolved in water for respiration. Thank you very much.